Kardashev Scale Type 3 Civilization, Beings with the Power of Gods. In 1964, the Russian astrophysicist Nikolai Kardashev developed a method that facilitates the search for extraterrestrial life by measuring the degree of the technological evolution of civilization and dividing them into three types, Type 1, 2, and 3. In this way, a Type 1 civilization can control the energy of a planet, Type 2 can control the energy of a star, and Type 3 can control the energy of an entire galaxy with technology so advanced that it would be no different for us from magic. What could a Type 3 civilization do? Stay tuned to find out. In the first and second parts of this series, we discuss Type 1 and Type 2 civilization on the Kardashev scale. Today, we will talk about a Type 3 civilization. On the Kardashev scale, the amount of energy is measured in watts. A Type 1 civilization is capable of consuming 10 to the power of 16 watts of energy. That is, the total energy that a planet like the Earth can provide, in which absolutely all forms of energy generation, such as solar, thermal, hydraulic, wind, among others, and even fission and nuclear fusion are used. A Type 2 civilization can consume 10 to the power of 26 watts of energy. This is all the energy that a star the size of the Sun can provide. A civilization that has reached these instances would have the technological ability to move planets, terraform every planet in the star system in which it is located, produce antimatter, and build a massive structure known as the Dyson Sphere, which would serve to make the most of all the energy produced by a star. And finally, the Type 3 civilization could consume a total of 10 to the power of 36 watts of energy. This is equivalent to the total energy that all the stars of an entire galaxy can produce. Technology of a Type 3 civilization. A Type 3 civilization would have technologies very similar to a Type 2 civilization, but taken to a galactic scale. Of course, they would also have completely new technologies that for now only exist in theory. Some of these technologies include use of supermassive black holes. Black holes are huge, massive bodies with a large amount of compacted mass in a tiny space. These are the product of the death of a star at least 10 times larger than the Sun and can't absorb everything close to them. Black holes have so much mass that they warp the space around them. Plus, they can absorb other black holes to get bigger and become supermassive black holes over time. Supermassive black holes are the densest bodies in the universe. Spiral galaxies like the Milky Way have supermassive black holes at their center, which can have billions of times the mass of the Sun. In 1974, the physicist Stephen Hawking theorized that the black holes produce radiation. This radiation was called the Hawking radiation. A Type 3 civilization on the Kardashev scale could build massive structures similar to Dyson spheres, but billions of times more significant, to take advantage of this radiation emitted by black holes, and could even take advantage of the space-time deformation that exists in the vortices of a black hole, to travel into the future due to time dilation. Use of quasars. Quasars are the most luminous objects in the known universe. They consist of galaxies in which the central supermassive black hole has begun to absorb everything within its reach, and the matter that makes up the galaxy starts to form part of the black hole's accretion disk. Due to this, a massive amount of energy is produced, released in the form of radio, infrared, light, ultraviolet, and X-ray waves. When a civilization reaches Kardashev scale 3, it could build a vast structure capable of harnessing the immense amount of energy a quasar produces. The structure they would use would be very similar to that used in a black hole. Still, for now, such technology is not possible to theorize for humans, since it does not exist. Or rather, no known material can resist the deformation caused by space-time. Of course, in addition to the technology to take advantage of these astronomical bodies, a Type 3 civilization would also have smaller-scale technologies that they would use to expand their civilization to the last corners of the galaxy. Evolution. Currently, humans are the only species known to create artificial organisms that serve us and help us fulfill our tasks more easily and quickly. Robots. Already for decades, fiction writers such as Isaac Asimov began to worry about the hasty advance of machines. This concern is perfectly reflected in his novel, I'm a Robot. where robots became aware of themselves and threatened the human race. Nowadays, computer technology and artificial intelligence that serves to control machines are advancing by leaps and bounds. In less than 50 years, we went from performing a few mathematical calculations to creating machines with human appearance and voices that imitate our expressions and are capable of learning. If things continue like this, the technology, we believe, will likely surpass us in intelligence sooner or later. The artificial organisms we have created evolve much faster than biological organisms. Biological evolution has made us human, but artificial evolution is much faster. In this scenario, a civilization that has expanded through the galaxy would see the disadvantage of being living organisms, since they would be limited by slow biological evolution. On the other hand, the machines and artificial intelligence that they created will evolve faster and better than them until they eventually surpass them in all aspects. To avoid this, a Type 3 civilization on the Kardashev scale must set aside biological evolution and become artificial beings, passing their mind and consciousness to artificial devices created by themselves. The members of this civilization would be utterly different from what we know. They would be neither biological nor artificial. They would be a mixture of both. In this way, technology would not surpass them, and they could live forever. In other words, the members of a Type 3 civilization on the Kardashev scale would be immortal beings. However, there is a second possibility, in which, as the Type 3 civilization expands through the galaxy, it will run into other extraterrestrial races that would also become part of its civilization either as members, as slaves, or as simple workers. In this sense, the second scenario is that a Type 3 civilization would not be made up of a single type of species, but would have a great variety of living beings of different races and from parts of the galaxy that would all coexist together with the same interstellar organization. For now, it isn't straightforward to determine which scenario would be the most realistic, since we have not yet encountered an extraterrestrial civilization. Information. Another essential aspect of civilizations is that as they expand, their knowledge also does. From the beginning of human history until 2010, approximately 5 exabytes of information were created, the same amount of data currently produced in a single day. As our civilization grows, so does our generation of information exponentially. A Type 3 civilization on the Kardashev scale would produce thousands of exabytes per second. Because of this, they would need to build quantum computers and other devices much more powerful than we can imagine today. Not only that, but by becoming artificial beings, they could have access to all this information instantaneously, having the reasoning of a biological being but the computing ability of a quantum computer. Control of space-time. A Type 1 civilization can control genes, alter the development of living things, and manipulate molecules. A Type 2 civilization can control subatomic particles and manipulate atomic nuclei at will. But a Type 3 civilization would be capable of all the above and could also manipulate the basic structure of space and time. Because they would have the technology to manipulate stars, they could also use the structure on which the entire universe is built. This would lead to the possibility of creating technologies that allow them to travel through the universe using machines that, for now, only exist in our imagination, such as the warp engine, which we already talked about in a previous video, about the technologies that extraterrestrials would use to bequeath to the Earth. With this technology, they could travel interstellar distances in fractions of time that for now are impossible to achieve in the universe. In this way, they would reach every corner of the galaxy in a few days instead of taking several thousand years. With the energy of a galaxy and the ability to manipulate space-time, such a civilization could create famous wormholes. Wormholes are hypothetical structures of which we do not yet have evidence of their existence. Still, according to theoretical physicists, to come into existence, these structures would be cracks in space that would serve as shortcuts to connect two very distant points of the universe and travel all that distance instantaneously. Although this technology only exists in movies, this kind of technology would be possible for a Type 3 civilization on the Kardashev scale. Possible examples of a Type 3 civilization. Imagining a Type 3 civilization is difficult in real life. However, in the world of science fiction, there are some attempts to capture what a society with these characteristics would be like. In Star Wars, an organization called the Galactic Empire is presented that consists of an army that has total domination over an entire galaxy, reaching members of its organization on each planet and having managed to populate all the solar systems of which they have reached. Science fiction writer Arthur C. Clarke once said, "Any sufficient advanced technology is no different from magic. This is because if a person carries modern technology to humans from 2,000 years ago, for them it would be so incomprehensible that they could not differentiate technology from magic. Members of a Type 3 civilization would have technology that would be no different from magic for us. They would be able to move stars, move solar systems, travel through space-time, manipulate black holes, and even life eternally. Rather than living beings, they would be the closest thing we can imagine to gods." Civilization Types 0, 4, and 5. When Nikolai Kardashev proposed the Kardashev Scale, he only raised the three types of civilizations discussed throughout this series. However, other specialists decided to expand the scale of the original Kardashev a little and add another three. Civilization Type 0. This is a civilization that is well below Type 1. This was created to place the human race within the scale. The society of humans is in Type 0, since we are not yet able to take advantage of the total energy of our planet. Civilization Type 4. Far above the Type 3 civilization that can control the energy of a galaxy is the Type 4 civilization, which consists of a society capable of handling the energy of multiple galaxies of the observable universe. Scientist Michio Kaku was the first to introduce this type of civilization within the Kardashev scale. He deduced that if there can be a civilization capable of controlling an entire galaxy, sooner or later, civilization will have the power to prevent the management of multiple galaxies of the universe itself. He also mentions that, if possible, for now, there is still no such civilization, since if it existed, we would have already realized because our galaxy would be under its control. Examples of a Type 4 civilization. If a Type 3 civilization is already difficult to imagine, a Type 4 civilization is even more so. However, some writers have tried to capture what the characteristics of a Type 4 civilization would be like. The first of these examples is the Galactic Frieza Army, which is the name by which it calls itself, a fictional army that appears in the anime series Dragon Ball Z, created by Akira Toriyama. This army is commanded by the Emperor of the Frieza universe, who is one of the main enemies of the protagonists. In the animated series, it is shown that the Galactic Frieza Army has managed to conquer the entire universe, and its main area of trade consists of finding habitable planets, eradicating any intelligent species that inhabit it, and then selling them to other extraterrestrial races looking for a place to settle. There is also the example of the 1965 novel Dune by writer Frank Herbert. In this novel, it is narrated that humanity has managed to populate the entire universe, although the primary outcomes happen in a single group of planets where a struggle for the power of a material that triggers an interstellar battle takes place. In both cases, it is shown that the technologies developed by both works of fiction allow them to travel throughout the universe without problems. Civilization Type 5. Finally, the Type 5 civilization can control all the energy provided, not only by the universe, but by all the universes that can exist. That is, maintain the energy of the multiverse. This last civilization falls totally within the category of fantasy, since for now we have no evidence that the other universes exist. We hope that you have been able to learn all the differences between the different types of civilizations on the Kardashev scale with this series.